Oh, yeah. Here we are. We're live, and we're all just now seeing Jeff's new hair.
Looks good, buddy.
Yeah.
What did you just straight up laugh?
I thought it earlier for my haircut, motherfucker.
How'd you make it so tall?
Jason probably did
that,
right?
I think some of it's an optical illusion here. Yeah, it's I think the lighting and the headphones are making it look more extravagant than it is. But maybe not. Maybe it's
extravagant is a good word.
What's that?
Yeah. Maybe it's extravagant awesome.
Is a good word. Oh, there's Shane. I see him down there, but he's not in the
there he is.
There he is.
There
he is. Woo! What's up, buddy?
Happy Tuesday.
Hi.
Hey, bud.
I was very scared of the technical. My phone, of course, was dying. My computer was dying. This is what always happens. But I'm here now.
Your feed looks extremely high resolution.
It does?
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like super high now.
Really good. A
very rich person's Wi-Fi. If that's a thing.
Can't tell it is. It definitely is.
I'm looking at you're sideways now.
That's
better. Let's keep it that way.
That's kind of cool, actually. Look at you.
Yeah.
Look, I'm talking.
You really gotta have a strong core to sit like that.
That's funny.
I am a little disappointed. I'm like 30 minutes from Shane. I really wanted to come do the shot in person, but
oh man,
it would have involved me sort of detaching my house because I'm in my roving recreational vehicle, so I would have had to kind of like throw shit together and drive there and then come back here. So, but I'm gonna come see you tomorrow.
Yes,
the roving recreational vehicle. That's the RRV. Well,
RV stands for roving vehicle. I don't know if you knew that, but
I did not. I thought it was recreational vehicle.
I think it's actually an RUV, right? Like it's a recreational utility vehicle. Isn't that what they call it?
That's absolutely not true. It's roving vehicle.
Are you sure it's not the urban assault vehicle?
I don't know. It's home for me.
Dude, if anyone here should be driving the urban assault vehicle, it should be you.
This guy right here. Who's got two thumbs and should be driving an urban assault vehicle? You'll never know because I'm holding a
phone. You should be flying a fighter jet is what you should be doing.
This is what we do, Shane. This is
– Well, it's really – it's just really good.
It's riveting, right?
I mean, maybe we should have our TV show too. Like, we get one.
Right. I mean, yeah, we could turn this into a TV show, right?
I got to say, I've become like – a late to the party Songland addict. I've watched every episode now.
Brad, you've been on the damn show.
I know, but for some reason, our episode is the only one that
he doesn't remember that.
Like Netflix special or whatever.
He was basically like, this show seems dumb, but I would do it in person, but I'm not going to watch it. And then he finally watched it.
Yeah, he's finally like,
how do I get made fun of for actually liking the show?
No, I just think it's actually probably the only one on here who's actually watched any more episodes. So
exactly. I'd like to.
No, not true. I watched.
So nobody, I love nobody else is like.
Yep.
Dude, that's so
a bad signal.
That hook. That one chorus that was like, try to remember the bad, try to remember the bad, try to remember the bad things. That shit was crazy.
I was honestly really mad I didn't get that song. I mean,
what a crazy
I worked with, but I loved that song so much. It didn't
did
even
you win that episode?
What's that?
Did you win that one, the Boys and Men one?
No. Ah. No. That was Esther. And the song that won was really good too, but that chorus just knocked me out.
Oh, that's right. It was that. That's it.
Yeah.
See, I am a fan, man. I can sing all the songs.
I love
it. I was going to say that song.
Jeff, did you cut your hair?
He did.
Maybe. Maybe I did.
When did you do this? Why didn't you call me?
I cut it like 20 minutes ago. I'm actually, I just had Jason do it, the guy that did the music video for something to do.
Oh, that's awesome. So you're down there? That's.
Shane, let me ask you this.
I am down there.
Okay.
When we talked to Jeff last, he said that he was thinking about getting a normal guy haircut.
Yeah.
Do you think that's a normal guy haircut?
I don't know. I can't really tell. I don't know if I would.
The lighting's not helpful, and the headphones aren't helpful. Hold on.
The most important thing, Jeff, is that you like it.
It looks good. Don't get us wrong.
It does look good, but it does not look, I would not call it like a normal guy haircut.
Right.
It looks sort of like Katie Lang.
Like if you were in Nashville and he picked you up from school, would you be like, yeah, that's my normal dad? Or would you be like, oh, that's my dad?
I would say that's my daddy.
Ooh. Yeah.
No, that I really good on you. I really do. But I think it looks good.
Hey Shane, have you been writing on Zoom?
Yeah.
What do you think of the Zoom?
It feels like this. Like I can't a lot of times this actually feels a little better because I can actually hear y'all at the same time. What Zoom is so hard because sometimes if you're writing with someone who's like not as talkative or outgoing, they'll just be going, and if they're not the loudest person, then you can't say. And they don't even know that you've like missed something they threw out. It's that thing, you know, when you throw something out in the room and no one responds, so you feel like nobody liked it. But right. The thing is, a lot of the shit nobody hears, and so you're like, oh, I guess somebody liked that.
But what normally happens for me is someone else says it, and I was like, yeah, that's amazing. And I'm like,
that happens with you in a normal ride, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. That happens in person all the time. It really makes me question whether I'm a good writer.
We'll let us answer it for you.
What's that?
I said, well, let us answer it for you. Yeah. Matt,
what do the people think?
A big haircut, too. But I mean, you've had a hat on.
It's actually growing out. It's getting longer.
Left.
Beard too. I can get the pirate beard going.
A while ago when Whit was on screen, were y'all just seeing Whit? Is it like this to y'all when Whit's sitting?
Whit always looks like, we always say Whit looks like he's taking a shit.
I'm not in the bathroom.
Amazing if that was part of
this is not like, my bathroom. I'm not there.
He has to be taking a shit.
He just looks like he's sitting on the toilet.
That's the shoulders. It's something about the shoulders.
Yeah, he's got the like lean.
I mean, yeah, it's like a. I could defecate from this position for sure.
I mean, that's a little tidbit that we can tell people about you when we're on the road is that sometimes you like to try to FaceTime people when you know that they're going to the bathroom.
That's just good, clean fun. Good, clean fun.
Shane, have you been enjoying the beach? Looks nice down there.
It's been nice. I feel really lucky that we've been down here for.
I like how you said that to Shane. Jeff's on an actual beach.
Well,
look, you're there all the time though. Oh, you're there all the time too.
Thank you, Brad, for the question.
You actually, you said something the other day on one of your Instagram posts that reminded me, like, you know, you were saying you're hanging out with Jesse down there and how, like, you know, something like that, like, it can only happen kind of one time or whatever, you know what I mean? Just how something unfolds. And it just kind of reminded me of that same thing, like moving to town and meeting the people that I met and like that kind of one musical era that just everyone was together and then everyone went their separate ways and it'll never happen again, you know, like in that particular moment or whatever.
That's just like what with Matthew and Trevor, we started writing together a long time ago and I know those guys were writing with other people and knew you guys, but we really can never, we always talk about like getting that original six people like back together. We used to take these retreats and stuff. And now because of what happened for us and obviously what we were all dreaming of back then, but now it's kept us from having like our, we used to even have a Christmas dinner.
So I think
it makes you start appreciating that when things happen like this, I don't think a lot of times we know, like with the time we had with Jeff Frazier and his wife, Stevie, just down the road, they were really some of the only people we've been in contact with. And no matter what happens, we will always be friends, but no matter what happens, it'll never be like this again. Yeah. And so we, you know, I think it's just as that happens before in your life, you start realizing.
It'll never be like this again.
Yeah,
shortest song of all time.
That was Brad's version of good story, bro.
No. I was just trying to be funny, and I'm the one who brought up the story, bro.
Yeah, bro.
I can't get knocked out for shit that I like today.
As to what everybody has, everybody been like binge watching anything? Because I'm like all out of shows, and I really do.
I started watching Little Fires Everywhere the other day. It was pretty cool.
I read that book. I started the show, but it's so different than the book.
Oh yeah, it's hard to go from book to a show anytime. It's or movie.
They really took some liberties.
Yeah.
Who else?
I watched. I just finished Peaky Blinders. Have you watched that?
I started watching it. I, you know what? I think I'm gonna have to commit because so many people love it. It started off so I just did not know what to expect.
Yeah, I tried that.
I got some really good advice from my buddy Tony before we started. I was thinking about it. He said, "What's that?"
I said, "I can't stand Tony."
He said,
"Don't do this."
Oh yeah, I mean he's a dick, but he gave me this one piece of advice. he said, "He goes, I hate sex." I hate subtitles, but he goes, watch it with the subtitles. And it made a huge difference. Like, I wouldn't have known what was going on.
Yeah, someone...
Because the accent's so thick and everything, but it was amazing.
Okay. I've heard that. Is it funny?
No.
Oh. See, for some reason...
No, there's a lot of...
the title gives me the impression that it's funny.
Yeah, it's a funny title.
No, it's kind of funny title, but it's like 20s Irish gangsters. It's pretty, you know, a little bit of violence and, you know...
Who else?
Nudity.
Oh, so all the shows. Nudity?
A little bit.
Okay. For my side?
Both sides, actually.
Okay. Both sides.
Okay.
Yeah.
What else? Who else? Jeff?
I don't know. What did I watch? I watched Alone. I couldn't stop.
We watched that. It's good.
What it's is awesome, it? Right?
I liked
Alone.
It.
Alone. It's like survivalist show.
What's it called?
Alone.
Alone. Oh, I thought... Yeah.
Alone.
I do want to see that. I saw a preview for it. It looked crazy.
Yeah, it's very cool. People go crazy, man. It's like it's maybe not like I was watching it so much one night that you know it's in the Arctic and I had to let my dog out and I was expecting it to be freezing cold when I opened the door. I was so into it. I was like, okay, gotta let the dog out.
I actually love that.
I'm like 10 years late to the party on New Girl. I found out I'm on season 2. It's really exciting.
Yes, that is not funny. At all what I expected you to expect.
Now I want to know what you were expecting.
I don't know. Something about, I don't know. I have no idea really, but New Girl, not what I
Great show. I mean, season 2 really good enough, I got to say.
It's
funny.
It's funny. I love it. Man, Witt's cracking me up. Witt is just laughing at
me. I'm sorry. New Girl's like 20 years old.
Yeah, it is.
That's what I said. I'm about a decade late to the party.
Jeff is so...
2 decades.
Jeff is so considerate on his thing where he hits mute every time after he says something. That's very kind. Nice. Thank you.
I'm at the beach, so it's windy. I'm trying to do my part.
Good.
I will say you sound the clearest. Like your audio when you talk is crystal clear. It's perfect.
Who?
It's me.
Thanks, man.
Oh, I thought you meant me.
No, Jeff. You're all over the place.
Trevor, yours is definitely the worst. You're like, your face is like boxes.
Yeah, it's like super, well, you know, it's not the best Wi-Fi in the RV, I would imagine.
Well,
should we take a shot or something?
Yeah, let's take a shot.
Yeah. Trevor, you look like a character, like you're dressed up like the Tiger King or something.
Shane, I'm living in an RV park right now. I'm trying to play the part. I'm Cousin Eddie right now. And when I come to your house tomorrow, I'm going to empty the shitter all over your lawn. Okay?
Oh, God. Oh, my God. That is funny. Okay.
Hey, Shane, how come? Oh, cheers. Shane, how come I didn't get any response on my dead bird today?
Oh.
Or yesterday?
Because I honestly knew we were going to do this, and I wanted to tell you in person.
I appreciate that.
I was really proud to receive that. You might want to tell people, or you might not want to tell people what that means. The probably people that are watching it, right? But Jeff very kindly sends me pictures of dead birds sometimes to remind me that he loves me, and to also remind me that life is short.
I actually send Jeff pictures now, and I see him because I know he's going to send them to you.
Yeah, it means a lot to me. He probably used some of y'all's and take credit for them. I know that I have a couple of people now that send me them, and I send them on to Jeff as if I saw.
Dude, I like this game. I like this game.
I like this game, too. I have a similar game with TJ Osborne, and I know a lot of people confuse you guys. And the game is that confuse you guys with the Brothers Osborne. The game that I play with him is chairs I don't want to sit in. So, like, sometimes there's
it's a good one.
Bathroom. And you'll just be like, who sits there? Nobody sits there. And so,
yeah,
that's a fun one, too. But not as good as...
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Once you tell me about the chair game, now I look for them, and they pop up.
They
pop up. The bathroom chair shows up more often than I'd like to.
I never noticed it before, but just a regular little chair in a bathroom. Who's sitting
there?
Yeah,
you don't want to sit that. I don't like the shower chair, the one that's obviously for assistance. I would never take a rest on that.
No.
Really?
Assistance.
No, I wouldn't. I never find myself wanting to plop down there.
Just sit.
You know, I'll say. I've never used it, but I've always wanted to.
Really?
That started because there was a chair at the top of a staircase in this very weird building in LA, and it was just a chair. And I was like, nobody's ever sat in that chair. And so I took a picture of it, and it started with another friend of mine, but TJ sort of picked it up and ran with it. There's a lot of things you can take pictures of, you know, dead birds. Chairs you wouldn't want to sit in. What? Yes. Yes.
What else?
Oh, well, I can't think of anything right now because I'm not in a good. I'm not firing on all cylinders right now. I think I miss y'all.
Neither and are we, man.
I want to be hilarious right now, but I can't because Whit. Just his picture in this little square is so much funnier than anything I could come up with.
That's how I roll, man.
Yeah.
That's what I do.
And Trevor with showing the wife beater with the kind of open.
You know what?
You are the tiger.
I'm at an RV park, Shane.
He's also kind of a, he also kind of looks like Joe Dirt's dad. Oh, no.
Oh,
no.
Oh, man.
Is that better?
It is.
I can end the live stream now.
I'm living at an RV park, man.
In an RV park?
He's glamping. Yes,
it's amazing, actually, this palm tree. Everywhere you go, there's like a different park along the beach. I'm in Destin. I've never been to Destin. Beautiful beach.
So, like,
it may be the most beautiful beach.
You don't have like a house that you're going into. You're just, that's it. You're there.
No, this is my house.
Okay. I got
roving.
Well, Brad, he just keeps sort of very, you know, lightly mentioning, oh, I'm in an RV. I'm in your area. What do you got?
Yeah.
It is like
– in an RV.
It's just like –
it could be anywhere like a 40-mile radius. I'm in your area when you're in an RV.
I'm in your state.
I'm glad to see you're finally using that thing.
Me too. I was about to sell it. I had it for about a year and then use it once.
Oh, I didn't
know. To the point it wouldn't start up when I tried to start it up. But I got it running, using it. It's amazing.
You got your brand new RV running. Nice.
Got it running. Unbelievable. Best purchase I've made in a long time.
Are you driving or can Amy drive it?
Oh, I drive it. It's small enough for her to drive, but she hasn't yet. At some point she will. I'll get really wasted and then she'll have to.
We wanted to do an RV thing, but then we just got a private plane. I just did.
Amazing.
Well,
this entire vacation this week's cost us $700. So,
oh, that is awesome.
Well,
yeah.
Congrats.
That's kind of like the equivalent to how much the private plane costs.
Exactly. Yeah. If you do for it, yeah.
Y'all are so
funny. I like this person that just asked the question, is Trevor in an RV?
If he says he's in an RV, this one more time. I feel like I have to take my shirt off.
Oh my God. What is happening?
Oh,
you know what? It feels
yes.
Right.
Yes.
Feels right.
This is the weirdest one we've ever done.
This is super weird.
Yeah. This is exciting and interesting turn.
That looks pretty good.
Is that like an Escot?
All right. Fine, I'll do it.
It is like an Escot.
So I'm gonna run out of this delicious Cantera Negra tequila if I keep drinking at this rate.
Oh man.
So
like I'm living a Joe Nichols song.
I have a question. How long did these go on?
Hey, that's a good question.
We got like,
at any moment like you would be like, two, I'm gonna go. See you later.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, usually we'd probably end it by now, but look at the way you're dressed right now. I'm not ending the thing.
I was just trying to look, guys. We are slim pickings here. I'm trying, you know what I mean? Y'all are going to have me on as a guest. I want to do something that you'll remember. Actually, what's funny is I've been working out with Derek like crazy, and now I see myself with no shirt on, and I'm like, I'm putting my shirt back on.
You look good, man. You look good. So I can tell.
We all work out with the same trainer, and I was gonna ask you guys if Derek does this thing where he'll like say some inspirational thing, like he'll go, just think of all the times people told you you couldn't do something.
Yeah, yeah.
I just hang up on him. I cannot stop.
Hey, what are you doing? That to you while you're working out?
Yes.
Oh, he says that to me too. Like when I'll be like, Ted, I can't do that. He'd be like, you think of all the times if you would have said you can't. Where would you be now?
I couldn't where I'd be off that Zoom call because I hit leave. I like it when you do that. It cringes me out. Stop it. Or one time he said, do it for your kid. And I was like,
yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. Were you able to do it?
No, I hung up on
it. Man, you must really hold back around me.
Dude, that's amazing. Do it for your kids.
He was like, come on, do it for your kids. And I was like, boop, goodbye.
Yes. There are a lot of good Derekisms. He has one that we always laugh about. He's like, you can do anything in 30 seconds. And he means you can do anything for 30 seconds.
For 30 seconds.
Wait, tell him about somebody that can do it.
Whip fell out.
Somebody tell, like, reenact when he does the inspiration speech, but then he comes back around.
Wait, what?
You know, when he's like talking about hope, but then he's like, if you don't like hope, then fuck you. Like, I can't do the, like, I can't do it.
He's so positive. But it's like a lot of times when he'll say some of his positive stuff about, you know, you got to just be good to people or whatever. I cannot help but think of you guys. Just like if he ever does that to y'all as a group, I mean, there's no way I could work out with him now in with more than one person. Because I would just, you know, like when you're with someone one on one, you're kind of like, yeah, man.
There's so many times that I'm like, I gotta remember this. I gotta remember this so I can tell everyone, but then I forget it all the time.
Derek, when you're watching this later, we love you. Thank you for all of your hard work.
Honestly, we love you. Yeah. We go back every day. I think he would have a good time with it. But I'm curious if he ever says those things of like, remember all the times that you said no. I was like, I can't. I said, Derek, this doesn't work on me. You have to stop. And then, you know, he forgets who does what. Because, shit, he'll try to work out my same muscle group 2 days in a row, and I'll be like, dude.
Yeah.
Like, I cannot move my legs right now. You cannot make me do a squat. So I think he forgets who he does and who does and doesn't like those aspirational. Is that it? Aspirational?
Aspiration.
Yeah. Either
one. We should have Derek on as a guest, have him work us out during the shot. We should take shots during
the workout. That would be the worst and best live stream ever if we live streamed our workout.
But we still have to do the shot during it, though.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a requirement.
Are y'all missing each other?
Who?
Can you tell?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yes. Yeah, for sure.
Doesn't it feel weird, though? I mean, honestly, like, to have been together so much for so long and then just like not be.
Yeah, we haven't been apart like this forever. I mean,
I know.
8 years, 7 years. Crazy.
We're down here with the like Karen and Jimmy from Little Big Town. They live close to us. And they were saying how they have not been away from Kimberly and Philip for 21 years. Like they have been together.
Yeah.
For 21 years. And she's like, we've never spent this much time apart. Like, it's really, that's just crazy. I mean, it's family. That is what you guys are.
Yeah, that's strange.
But anyway, I was just curious if y'all miss each other.
Let's do one more shot because people don't.
Hey, before I go, I just want to let you know. Before I go, I want to let y'all. Okay. I gotta say something. For as weird as this particular hang got, being on Venice Beach, I wish to God I could show you how weird things are getting right in front of me.
Turn it around, man. Let's see.
Turn the camera around.
Let's do it.
You can do it.
I'm going to turn it around, but I'm going to let you know. I've been watching someone assemble a stolen sectional onto the pier the whole time we've been talking.
a couch sectional?
Yeah, got to be.
Like for outdoor use?
I can't really see it.
Yeah, go over there. Get closer.
Go sit on it.
Yeah, you're going to have to.
Yeah, no, the guy's still building.
Go pretend that it's yours.
Oh.
Just be like, hey, dude.
No. Hey, for real. Someone stole our bike down here at the beach, and I went and got it from him because I saw where he went. And I just went up to the guy. I was like, dude, you took our bike. And he was like, oh. And he just got off the bike and put the kickstand down and walked.
Well, that's awesome. I mean,
that's probably the best.
That's great.
That's a great outcome.
So,
yeah, it really is.
Yeah, I would call it the best case scenario.
Just go do it. Okay, shot.
All right. Hey, this has been fun.
Right, yeah, man. It's fun.
Been fun. Shane, I'll see you tomorrow.
I will.
Just give him Jesse's address.
Hey, Trevor, can you shotgun a beer real quick?
Oh, dude, do it.
Do it. Let me see if I got any. See if I got any beer in the fridge.
He's going to do it. He's taking you seriously.
Oh my God, I'm not leaving.
Let's see what else we can get him to do.
He's gonna do it.
He's going to do it.
He's got to do it.
That's really hoping I can find a friend.
Were you laughing at me or him?
You laughed
But
how do you shack on a beer? What do? You poke
all right,
a
right.
Bottom. Go to the bottom.
You gotta poke a tiny hole.
You have,
dude. Use your keys.
No.
I don't have keys. Oh, I do have keys. It's a recreational vehicle. Hang on a second.
He's from Michigan, and he just asked how you count.
I can't believe it. So hold the beer like this, Trevor.
And then bite it.
Hold like this.
No.
Now open it.
Wrong hand.
Man, that was rookie as hell.
That was
it really was. Here, let me do another one. I can do it better.
This is some solid RV park antics right here.
It really is.
These are the only reason I tried.
Man.
I've only drank half the bottle.
All right.
Well, all right. With that.
I think that's
yeah. Good luck.
Yeah, that's how you ended right there.
All right.
Love you guys. Bye.
See ya.
All right.